evening, everyone, and welcome to the Calvin Teacher Commissioning. I'm Brian Bolt, Dean of Education, and on behalf of everyone in the teacher education program, I want to express our warmest greetings to the families and friends that have joined us here to celebrate on this special occasion. We're having to adapt, but one thing has not changed. Like Calvin has been doing for more than 100 years, we're excited to send a new group of teachers out into the world. So, let's get started. We have a special guest tonight. He's an educator at heart, and he has a message for all of you. I think you'll recognize it.
I wish to offer my warmest greetings to our education graduates here today and to your loved ones gathering around you. Congratulations on this momentous step in your vocational journey. What a blessing it is to take this time to celebrate not just the completion of your degree, but your calling to the field of education. As you launch from this program, you carry on the legacy of alumni who've gone before you and of our education faculty. As they demonstrated for you, you will also live out the principles of excellence, compassion, and justice in your roles as educators and faithful followers of Christ. Schools know Calvin graduates by their hearts for service and the way in which they nurture their students. And they will know you by the same spirit and by the way that your students flourish. I also want to take this moment to express my gratitude to the family and friends of our graduates. Thank you for your enduring support for your student throughout their studies and the encouragement you will show them throughout their lives and careers. Graduates, I wish you God's grace and peace and congratulate you on all that you have accomplished. May you be blessed knowing, loving, and serving God as you seek renewal in the classroom and in the wider world.
Thanks, President Leroy, and thanks for your support of our students and our teaching graduates. We celebrate with you. We celebrate the teachers who have prepared and practiced and are equipped to think deeply about students and instruction and schools. Teachers who are poised to overturn injustice on behalf of communities and families and districts and kids of all ages. And teachers who lead with their hearts, that physical organ that beats in your chest and that vital life force given by God. It's the heart that allows empathy for the struggling child, the heart that expresses gladness at a job well done. It feels sorrow and tragedy, and the heart provides resolve not to back down no matter what. It's that same heart that delivers oxygen to play, to sing, to compete, to create, and to dance. Did I say dance?
I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide, left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we about to slide. You can't let this one slide. I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide, left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we about to slide. You can't let this one slide.
Why? Need a freak, need a freak, map, why? Need a freak, need a freak, map, why? Need a freak, need a freak, map, why? 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 Need a freak map, why? Need a freak, need a freak map, why? Need a freak, need a freak map, why? Why? Why?
You think you've seen it all? Wait.
I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide, left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we about to slide. You can't let this one slide. I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide, left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we bout to slide. Hey, can't let this one slide. Hey.
Well, we're sorry you had to see that. But never let it be said that Calvin faculty and staff don't go the extra mile. Now here's 2020 teaching graduate Anna Quist to introduce our featured speaker.
Good evening, fellow graduates, families, and Calvin faculty. My name is Anna Quist, and tonight I have the honor of introducing our speaker, Professor Ken Bergworth. Professor Bergworth began working in the education department at Calvin in 1999 and joined the geology department in 2001. I feel honored to introduce him today as he was one of the first people to encourage me to look into the profession of teaching. Professor Bergworth is an inspiring educator who deeply loves the Lord and the work the Lord has given him to do. His awe for God is palpable in his teaching of science and in his caring interactions with those he comes in contact with. His encouragement is one of the reasons I am graduating as a science teacher today, and I feel so much gratitude to have learned to teach from one so clearly meant to do so. Please join me in welcoming Professor Ken Bergworth.
In Matthew 25, Jesus tells the story about three people that were given talents. He was talking about you. He gave you talents and abilities. Then he made it possible for you to attend Calvin. And while you were here, you developed those skills. You added to them. They increased, they multiplied. And now, just like 2,000 years ago, he is saying, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You've been faithful over a few things. Now I will put you in charge of many things." But the rest of that verse, that says that you will share in his joy. That's my prayer for you as well, that you will find joy in your work. You will also find that that joy takes many forms, and it's going to put you in interesting positions. As you work toward that joy, you will be wearing many hats. Of course, one of those hats is teaching math. And of course, another one of those hats will be teaching social studies. And then there's the teaching of reading, a new hat. And of course, the teaching of science, which Francis Collins calls the language of God. I like that. But you are also going to be wearing a very different hat. The hat of character. Your students will be watching you, and they will see much more than academic instructions. In 20 years, your students will remember some things about you. Now, they probably will not remember if you were the one who taught them how to diagram a sentence or what haiku is. They probably will not recall if you were the one who taught them the location of Algeria or the capital of North Dakota. However, they will remember your character. You are the physical representation of Jesus. The Jesus with skin that they can see and hear. Just as today, there are certain teachers that stick out in your memory, the hat that you wear shows the character of Christ. And wearing that hat will bring you joy for a lifetime, and it will impact generations of your students. Well done! You have been faithful in your work here at Calvin. Now, go out and be in charge of many students. And may you find joy in being the representative of Jesus in your work.
now it's time to honor the graduates. Congratulations, graduates. You have shown resilience and flexibility and faith in a very unusual time. I'm Marge Terpstra, and I'm a professor in the Education Department, and I'm pleased to introduce the graduates in the Early Childhood Program. Julia Blanker. Alicia Lumens. Katie Peterson. Cassidy Skolton. Haley Stackpole.
I'm Professor Al Borma, and I've had the privilege of participating in the preparation of some of our elementary education candidates. I want to congratulate all of our teacher education program graduates on this important milestone, transitioning from their training to classrooms of their own. Judy Cho. Amanda DeYoung. Libby Engel. Jen Harkbarth. Shin Han. Mallory Hotland. Emma Johnson. Sumyoung Sharon Kim. Judy Ko. Jess Locke.
I'm Sandra Vrone. It's my honor and privilege to congratulate and welcome you to the teaching profession. Morgan Lukies. Shannon McNerney. Joshua Mulker. Anna Quist. Holly Stebbins. Sophia Staub. Noah Treffers. Aaron Van Baren.
Hello, I'm Professor Kate Strader, and I am honored to be able to recognize the 2020 graduates in special education. Michaela Batches. Olivia Boomstra. Lindsay Bruni. Libby Carter. Lily Estrella. Josie Fox. Skylin Giro. Bree Heiniger. Esther Kim. McKenna Miller. Danny Roskamp. Kyla Swanson. Lauren Van Vucht. Madison Vanderhoof. Margaret Van Wylen. Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Hi, my name is Joanne Van Riewijk. I am pleased to announce today four certified art education teachers: Emily Cook, Jamie Kuiper, Brittany Postma,
My name is Dr. Jerry Bergsma, and I have the privilege of working with our candidates in the kinesiology department who have their focus in K-12 health and physical education. Congratulations to you for the work you've completed. God's blessings as you begin your career in education. Carlos Amaros Gutierrez. Carla Dykstra.
Hello, everyone. My name is Crystal Bruxport, and I have the privilege of teaching and learning alongside teacher candidates in secondary science. This year's graduates include Gabby Allred, Joseph Choi, and Morgan Scott. Congratulations to all of you.
I'm Karen Salpi from the English department.
I'm Christine Johnson, and I teach in the English department.
The English education graduates are Brady Baim, Susanna Borsma, Stephanie Hagerty, Nicole Hellinger, Erin Knapper,
Mallory Mainz, Katie Rosendahl, Maddie Sensenig, Abby Vetters, and Lauren Zeiderveen.
Congratulations all.
Hello, my name is Dr. Dave Klanderman, professor of mathematics education here at Calvin. And on behalf of my colleagues in the mathematics and statistics department, it's my privilege to congratulate those completing the secondary math education program this year. And those students include Allie Boyd, Emily Gunderson, and Mike Cool. Congratulations to all.
Hello, I'm Stephen Staggs, the advisor for the History and Social Studies Education Program. On behalf of my colleagues in the History Department, I want to congratulate those graduating from the program. Dear scholars, we praise and thank the Lord for each and every one of you, for you have blessed us beyond measure. Now, without further ado, the graduates from the History and Social Studies Education Program. Andrea Gerrits, Luke Herman, Jacob Hildebrandt, Shin Kim, Henry Rautenberg, Sarah Spichalski, Annika Stahl, Joshua Sternberg, Joseph Turcott. Congratulations to each and every one of you.
Hello, I'm Abraham Ceballos, Professor of Spanish and Language Education. It's been my privilege to work with our world language teacher candidates of Chinese, French, and Spanish. You've reached the end of your teacher preparation program and endured a final semester with many challenges. You tackled them with your brilliant minds, kind hearts, and generous spirits. Today, I join you celebrating your accomplishments. Sus logros son mis logros. Le courage dont vous avez fait preuve est une source d'inspiration. Qian Li, Xu Xing, Xu Yu, Xu Xia. I hope you always respect teaching as a vital responsibility and a humble one. May you thrive and be full of joy in the work that is ahead. Our teacher candidates: Yingbing Chen, Marguerite Dan, Joe Ellis, Amberly Green, Kendra Camps, Justine Lenquist, Brenna Rivas. Congratulations.
Recognize this place? Miss it?
It's a new world, isn't it? In fact, you've had to make a lot of adjustments, and we're really proud of the way that you handled yourself this spring. In fact, we're excited to send you a mask just like this. You don't know what your future holds. You don't know if you'll be using it in the spring, and so we're excited to send you one of those. Before we leave here, though, maybe we should take a walk. It's dark out there and there's no one here. You've spent a lot of time in these classrooms. In fact, you did a lot of thinking, a lot of growing. You listened to professors, you talked to your classmates, you made decisions, you changed your mind. In the halls here, you would sat down with professors and they advised you, but maybe you just popped in. Here's Professor Jolderson's door. Professor Genzink, all the way down the hall, all through these halls, are professors who you connected with. And all the while, you were meeting friends, making new ones, and joining the community. How about this? This is the office. Take a look. You remember the copier. Mailboxes. If you had a question about certification, it was Sherry you came to talk to. If it was about placement, how about Gwen? And if you just needed a smile, Debbie was always great to talk to. Well, they're all still here and they'll all be back, but we're ending in kind of a strange way. You know, you were never meant to be here that long anyway. We know that. In fact, the whole point was for this to be temporary. You were meant to go out and engage the world as teachers, to go make a difference, be agents of change. And we are so excited that you are setting out on this adventure. Before we end here, we're going to leave you with some words from a guy named Herb Cole. He was an author in one of your textbooks. I'm sure you've read them all. And then Professor Bersma will close out with some scripture. Thank you. Thank you to all of you for being a part of our lives for 4 years, and we want you to stay connected with us for years to come. Thank you for making Calvin world class.
Protect and nurture yourself.
Have some fun in your life.
Learn new things
that only obliquely relate to issues of social justice.
Walk. Play ball. Play chess. Swim.
Fall in love.
Give yourself in love to someone else.
Don't forget to laugh or feel good about the world.
Sing with others. Tell stories.
And listen to other people's stories.
Have fun so that you can work hard.
And work hard so that you and your parents and students
can have fun without looking over their shoulders.
This is not a question of selfishness,
but one of survival.
Don't turn teaching for social justice
into a grim responsibility,
but take it for the moral and social necessity that it is.
And don't be afraid to struggle for what you believe.
For we pray that God's glorious riches will strengthen you with power through His Spirit in your inner being, so that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith. And that you, being rooted and established in love, may have power together to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ. And to know this love that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled to the measure of all the fullness of God. Now to God, who is able to do immeasurably more than we can ask or imagine,
according to God's power at work within us. To him be glory forever and ever. Amen.
A place where growth happens.
Exciting, engaging, equipping, elevating, and encouraging.
A community of inspiring people.
Kelvin makes me creative, inclusive, and full of love.
Stressful, challenging, inspiring, rewarding, and unforgettable.
Kelvin is my home to learn and grow.
Everyone is welcome here.
During my time in the Calvin Education Program, I have felt supported, and my experience has been formative, challenging, rewarding, and inspiring.
Amazing professors and amazing placements.
Made my childhood dream reality.
My time in the Calvin Education Program has been engaging, collaborative, insightful, fun, and unforgettable.
Great professors, classmates, and experiences.
Selflessly and wholeheartedly impacting young lives.
Motivating, insightful, challenging, respectful, and shalom.
Inclusive community and supportive leadership.
Challenging, open-minded, diverse, and unforgettable experiences.
My experience with the Calvin Ed Department constantly affirmed my love for teaching.
Fun, yet challenging, stressful, yet very rewarding, and overall empowering.
Made my dream of becoming a teacher my reality.
Friends, fun, hard work, and fulfillment.
Fun, inspiring, caring, encouraging, and enlightening.
So many dang lesson plans.
During my time as a Calvin Education student, I've felt so cared for by the professors, and I'm so excited and feel very prepared for my future as a teacher.
Calvin's Ed program has challenged me, changed me, and helped me realize my dream of becoming a teacher.
We're all in this together.
Calvin's education program has not only inspired me to struggle for justice in the world, but in my classroom as well.
It's all about the kids.
My time in Calvin's education department has been radical, rigorous, humanistic, progressive, and comprehensive.
I would say journey to becoming Christ-like teachers.
Beauty comes from multiple trials.
Experiential, extensive, exponential, extraordinary, exciting.
I am so thankful for my time in Calvin's education department, but if I had to describe it in 5 or 6 words, it would be to answer the call to join God in what he's doing.
Teachers loving learning and loving students.
The best 4 years of learning.
Amazing, justice-oriented, intentional, vocation-affirming, home.
The most rewarding journey ever.
It's our turn to teach.
You're still here? It's over. Go home. Get a job.